Here is a quick refresher on the memory hierarchy of a processor. As you know, between the CPU and the main memory, there are several levels of caches. And typically these days, you may have it up to three levels of caches between the CPU and the memory. And the nature of the memory hierarchy is that you can have something that is really fast, a small amount of, or really slow, and a big amount of. And so all of these choices that are in between are really in between the two extreme choices of an L1 cache and the main memory. The disparity in the CPU cycle time and the main memory, if you take the disparity between the CPU and the main memory, it's more than two orders of magnitude today, and it's only growing. So any hiccup that the CPU has in not finding data or instructions that it needs to execute the currently running thread in the caches, and it has to go all the way to the memory, is bad news in terms of performance. So what this suggests is that in picking the next thread to run on the CPU, it'll probably be a very good idea if the scheduler picks a thread whose memory contents are likely to be in the caches, if not in the L1 cache, at least in the L2 cache, if not in the L2 cache, at least in the L3 cache, so that it doesn't have to go all the way to the memory in order to get the instructions and data for the currently running thread. So that's an important point to think about.